Welcome to live streaming from Unity with Amazon IVS. A blog series created to guide you through the various ways that game developers can integrate live, interactive, real-time streaming with Amazon IVS directly into a game created with Unity. In this video, we'll introduce you to Amazon IVS, discuss why you might want to create an integrated streaming experience in your game, and provide a preview of the various concepts that we'll be covering in this series. Let's get started. What is Amazon IVS? If you're new to Amazon IVS, allow me to give you a brief introduction. Amazon IVS is an AWS service that empowers developers to use the same live streaming technology and global infrastructure that powers Twitch to build their own applications. Amazon IVS provides three major capabilities: RTMP-based streaming with around 2 to 5 seconds of latency, real-time streaming with latency as low as 300 milliseconds, and highly performant and scalable WebSocket-based chat. In the context of this blog series, Amazon IVS enables game developers to build deeply customized and tightly integrated live streaming applications for their player base, which allow for more engagement and greater control over the total experience. This will lead to dynamic, interactive gameplay never seen before. Things like monetization, moderation, stream playback experience, viewer integration, chat integration, and much more are all in the developer's control. If you want to learn more about Amazon IVS, check out ivs.rocks. So, why live stream directly from a game? Game streaming is hugely popular, but you already know this. Your player base may already be live streaming via third-party software like OBS, and with the announcement of things like enhanced broadcasting on Twitch, that will always be a viable and sometimes preferred way to stream for some of your players. But let's be honest, configuring OBS isn't the easiest thing to do for some players. Things like bitrate, B-frames, codecs, keyframe intervals, and more can be kind of daunting to someone who just wants to stream their gameplay to an audience. By allowing your players to stream directly from the game, you remove that barrier to entry for some players, while giving all players the ability to have enhanced gameplay through feedback from viewers. What about multiple camera angles for viewers? Things like boss cams. What about user-controlled cameras? Yes, really. These cameras can allow viewers to pan, tilt, zoom, and spin a camera and watch at whatever angle they want without affecting the player's camera. How about modifying the environment or NPC behavior based on chat or polls? Yep, all of this and much more is possible when you integrate the streaming experience directly into your game. Now I'm sure that your gears are already spinning with the potential of live streaming directly from a game created with Unity. In this series, we're going to cover the following topics. First, we'll start with the basics: broadcasting directly from a game built in Unity to an Amazon IVS real-time stage. Next, we'll see how to enhance the broadcast and include the heads-up display in the broadcast. Then we'll see how to integrate Amazon IVS real-time chat directly into a game. Next, things get super interesting and fun when we start to see how to create dynamic and interactive streams with things like user-controlled cameras and dynamic environments and objectives. Next, broadcasting multiple cameras in real-time so that viewers can view both or toggle between the different cameras. Then we'll see how to integrate real-time stream playback, which opens up the possibility of things like squad chat with video. Part 8 is my favorite, when we see how to pull all of these techniques together in a game built for the Meta Quest VR headset. And if you're just looking to integrate broadcast directly to Twitch, we'll close out the series by seeing how this is possible. Now, I should add a disclaimer here. While I've got 20 years of experience as a full-stack developer, I'm not a game developer. All of the things that we'll be building will be based on existing demo games that are available via Unity Hub. Now, I've spent a lot of time building these demos, but there may be some concepts related to building a game with Unity that I'm less familiar with. I'll do my best to explain things, But remember, I am not a game dev expert. If you're going to follow along with this series, here are a few prerequisites. You'll need to have Unity Hub installed to follow along with this series and build along with me. You'll also need an AWS account to create a real-time stage and generate the tokens needed for broadcasting to that stage and any other resource that we may use in this series. Now, we've got a lot of ground to cover, and it's all super exciting stuff. By the end of this series, you'll be able to create your own engaging, highly interactive, and dynamic live streaming platform and integrate it directly into your game created with Unity. Head on over to the first post to learn how to get started broadcasting a game in less than 15 minutes.